just Jeff and I doing a quick ride, trying to get one in before it gets way too hot as we get into summer.
Beautiful day, high 70s, low 80s, something like that. For a mellow ride, maybe 20 miles or so.
Here we're climbing out of the northeast end of the big valley. Feels rockier than I remember. Of course, I've been riding this trail for about 12 years now, so. This is on the far northeast end of Burma Road. Obviously a big shale section that's been cut out, I assume by the strip mining back in years past. Now we're returning parallel to the Paul Road we went out, and we're coming up on a short little rocky section that's been giving me a lot of trouble in the last few weeks. But I managed to clear it this time, so That's an improvement. There's a little transit section of highway we're going to sneak down. Not very long. And of course I have to pass Jeff. He goes a little slow because he's got moose in his tires and doesn't want to overheat them on the pavement. And this is a hot day, so even though it only says 75 on the temperature gauge in the sun, it's brutally hot. Heading up to the famous Matto's Overlook, which is a good stopping spot, but we're not going to stop for long because it's pretty hot in the sun. But it's a neat view. Somebody has blocked the bypass, so the only choice here is to go through the puddle. It's only axle deep, so it's not too bad. This is going down the Nothing Hill, which I managed to do a very mediocre job of picking my line, so I'm sort of going down the rut with all the rocks. But being a little more tense than usual, but it wasn't that big a deal.
That was not the right line.
It's nothing though now for us.
Coming up to Rich's single track, and while it's not a secret, it's getting overgrown very quickly. The elephant ears are pretty brutal. And I really do like to be able to see where I'm going. Thank you. Now we're leaving the overgrown trail and taking one that's at least well enough used so that it's worn in. This section here is actually very pretty. It doesn't show on the camera, but there's gullies on either side that are nice woods. This might even have been an old railroad bed because it's so smooth and distinct from the gullies on the side. A little bit challenging to find the trail in here. This is a steep and loose trail, and since it's all overgrown now, I needed Jeff to get out of the way so I could sort of fall down it myself. A new tree across the trail. Tempted to get out my landscaping equipment, but Jeff always gives me a hard time when I stop to cut down the bushes. This is actually Eagle Hill Road. It's an official county road. I think we're in Schuylkill County, but it's a pretty brutally rocky trail. I don't think a car would have much fun coming up this road, but you know, a 4x4.
And the famous Silver Creek, the creek. Coming up to the Triple Pond, and while the temperature gauge says it's not that warm, in the direct sun, it's a very hot day. So we're not going to spend a lot of time here. We're going to go ahead and head on to someplace with a little more trees involved. This trail will take us to the backside of the Casca column pile. We usually approach it from the other side and guys climb the cliffs. But this is kind of an interesting little trail. A lot of azaleas in bloom along here. Not azaleas, rhododendrons in bloom. You can see the pink colors as we go along. That hill right there was where Jeff fell a few years ago. That was your spot, right?
Yes, that was it.
He cracked some ribs it stuck with him for a few months, as usual.
Weird. There's this black goo.
I see it.
And the foot, the hit my.
Yeah, I thought it stuck right into it.
Yeah.
We're turning around till there was a tree down across the road. And it looked like it would take a little longer to saw than I really felt like doing with my handsaw. Trees up to about 4 or 5 inches in diameter are pretty quick. But once they get bigger than that, it takes a while.
Thank you.
approaching the Silver Creek again, crossing to the west, of course. This is going up Eagle Hill Road. I found it's more comfortable if you go a little bit faster. So I'm trying to keep a little bit of speed up, let the suspension work. And here we are at the trailhead. Nice ride, 20 miles, 21 miles.